guys, Kath here. I'm in my kitchen drinking a diet tonic and lime while I'm preparing dinner, and thought I would give you a tutorial on pomegranates. This is a pomegranate. You want to get one that's heavy for its size because it means you've got lots of juice. Now, I'm left-handed, so bear with me here. First, you want to cut the sides off. So I will just cut that off. You can already see the fruit. And then you want to come over to the other side and look at my scar on my index finger. That's where I stuck the knife in my finger just a little few months ago. So I'm going to cut the other side off, and this is quite messy. I probably should change shirts. Then I'm going to switch here to my little tiny favorite knife, and I'm going to start making some cuts down the side to make the peel easy to come off. And again, I really actually make the husband do this most of the time because I am just afraid of knives after my little stab the finger incident. But you want to do this all the way around, and it just kind of loosens the skin. And just be really, really careful with the knife. Okay, so then you're going to come over to your bowl of water, and you are going to start breaking open the sections. And here they are, all the delicious, healthy pomegranate seeds. I think they're called arils. Some people call them kernels, but I just call them seeds because, frankly, that's easier to type on my keyboard than arils, and I never know how to spell it. So once you get kind of all your sections apart like this, you want to submerge the sections, and you just take your fingers and you just wiggle them around in there, and you try to get as many of these nice little seeds as you can. And 2 minutes later, we have separated this lovely cork material that floats. And the reason you do this in a bowl of water is because the arils sink to the bottom and the cork floats. So you can just kind of pull this out. And you might get a little bit of the cork material in your seeds, but, you know, it's okay if you eat it. It's probably just good for the gut and everything. So, you know, in typical fashion, I'm going to have to taste these here. What you want to do next is just take a colander and drain them out. But they're great on salads, and they're just great for eating.